All right, today we have 7 tips on how to avoid puppy scams online. My name's Donnie Gardner with the Boston Terrier Society. This is gonna be geared towards Boston Terriers because I get this question a lot. Like, is this website a scam? Am I being scammed? I've gotten this in the Facebook group as well as just emails. So here's 7 tips that you can do to avoid getting scammed when buying a Boston Terrier puppy. Tip number 1, absolutely avoid websites that are generic. When I say generic, they just have stock photos of Boston Terriers. Readers are going to be super proud of their Bostons. They're going to be in pictures with their Boston. So if you're not finding that on the website, I would just avoid it because chances are it's not a reputable site. Not saying there aren't people out there that do it, but just avoid it and then you'll be in the clear. Avoid websites with generic stock photos. Number 2, ask others who have Boston Terriers, hey, where'd you get your Boston Terrier? Do you like the breeder? This is what I'd recommend to everybody before they get started at all. Contact people that have Boston Terriers and find out where they received them. I do have a Boston Terrier Society group. Now, you cannot ask to buy or sell Boston Terriers within the group, but you can definitely join it. If you see somebody that has a cute Boston that you like, just feel free to message them, but you can't ask within the group. So that's a little insider tip trick. Number 3, if you cannot get your Boston Terrier breeder on the phone, so let's say you see a Boston, you love it, you want to go ahead and find out how you can buy it, and you email them, and all they want to do is email communications, that to me is a red flag. The breeder is going to want to get you on a phone and talk to you in person, because a reputable Boston Terrier breeder is going to care who their Boston Terrier is going to. They're not going to be doing things through email and then just ship you a Boston Terrier, which a lot of these websites say they'll do. They'll be out of state and they're like, yeah, we'll ship you the Boston Terrier. No, the breeder's going to want to get on the phone and actually talk to you. If for some reason they don't have the time to talk to you, I would go to a different breeder because they should care as much as where their Boston Terrier is going, as much as you should be concerned with where is it coming from. Number 4, this is a great way just to avoid all scams, I think, is buy local. I mean, if you know where the Boston Terrier breeder is, you know where their house is, well, that'll help clear any fraud up if you happen to run up against any. So buying local leads to my next tip is number 5, you need to visit the home of the puppy. This is gonna allow you to see how they treat their Boston Terriers. It's also gonna allow you some interaction before you actually purchase the Boston Terrier, which is great. I mean, that's what Cesar Millan recommends. Before you get a dog, you should play with it. So if you're buying local, then you can go ahead and visit the puppy on site. And I would do this even if you're going out of state to go get a Boston Terrier. You wanna visit it. Now, breeders will ask for some sort of deposit, and that's absolutely acceptable and okay. Every reputable breeder does ask for some sort of deposit. Just make sure you're doing that third step as far as getting them on the phone and actually talking to them before you send a deposit. Never just send the deposit. You want to have contact with that breeder. Text message and emails do not count. So number 6, you know, after you visited the puppy, number 6, just avoid websites like Craigslist. If the breeder doesn't have time to create a website or even a Facebook page about their Boston Terriers and it's just a Craigslist listing, I would avoid it. Sure, there's people out there that have Boston Terriers that they put on Craigslist. Maybe they're great, but if you're trying to avoid puppy scams, just don't even bother going there to look for it. Number 7, this kind of leads it from the Craigslist, but number 7 is go to the Boston Terrier Club of America. They have a referral program of Boston Terrier breeders. These are people that are in good standing with the club, and you can actually go to their websites and check out their Boston Terriers. So I have a story of Eric. He actually got Bruno and Frank, 2 Boston Terriers. Eric lives up in Boston. He flew all the way to Florida because he found a reputable breeder on the Boston Terrier Clubs of America referral program. He flew down there, got his 2 Bostons, and flew back home. So it's possible to buy out of state, but if you're using something like the Boston Terrier Club of America referral program, it just helps protect you. So as long as you follow these 7 tips, you know, you're contacting the breeder via phone, you're visiting the puppy on site, things of that nature, it'll help you avoid the scams. I know the biggest concern for me would be the deposit. As long as you talk to them over the phone before you actually send the money, and you're sending the money via like PayPal, possibly even check, I would avoid things like Green Dot, you know, those little cards that you can get at Walmart. That's like a surefire way that it's a scam. Anyways, hope this helps. If you have any questions or concerns, please leave a comment below. Also, if you want to learn more about Boston Terriers, be sure to click subscribe to this YouTube channel to get more information, or you can actually join the Boston Terrier Society Facebook group. The link will be below. Thanks again, and I'll talk to you guys later.